If you use OneNote with a stylus, I've got something to show you. So watch for the next 30 seconds. I'm not going to talk through this. You just need to watch and see what's going on. I'm going to open a palm rejection window because my computer has horrible palm rejection. And we're going to tap on the screen. I can do a lot of typing this way, but when you're typing this way, you want to switch away from the text pen because it doesn't support certain types of voice commands, like saying new paragraph. Choose cut. Okay, now we're going to switch off of the text pen to the selection tool. And now when we're typing with our voice, we can say things like new paragraph. It'll drop down two lines, new line. And to drop down one line, you can say new line. I think this is the fastest way to work and most enjoyable way to work inside of OneNote. So I really like this process using the text pen, using a combination of text expansion. I'm going to show you really quickly. So I used this little emoji here, and I also expanded out my email address. By the way, you can send me an email here if you have questions on what I'm doing. Let me explain now a little bit on how I'm triggering the text expansion. So I have Tablet Pro Studio running. Let's minimize this palm rejection window. The side button on the stylus, I have a two-button stylus. You can do this with a one-button stylus. It's a little bit different process, and I will go into that in another video. Okay, so I have the barrel button, which is the right-click button. I have this set to radio menu set to last. That means it'll open up the last one I did. If you have a one-button stylus, choose advanced. And I have invert set to previous two radial actions. Okay, so let's open up the radial menu. The outside buttons here, these get repeated. Two of them get repeated when you press the invert button, the front button. On a single button stylus, that is the only button that you have. This is the barrel button. On a slim pen two, same thing there. All right, so what you're going to do on that stylus, you're going to hold the stylus vertical, press and hold the button, and tap it on the screen. This will open up the radial menu. And then whatever of these outside eight buttons you click, let's do this twice. Now when I press the side button on a two-button stylus, this is going to be the front button, the invert button, or the eraser button. This is going to jump back and forth between the last two things I selected from the outside ring here. Now I have text expand on the inside. So when I use that and I open up the radial menu, it's going to stay centered here. I don't have to look at it anymore. I just open and click straight down and it does the text expansion. Okay, let's open this back up and let's do a new one. So I like smiley faces when I'm typing so people know that I am not angry. course, not writing all in caps might help, but it's fun. Okay, so let's write the word smile. And until OneNote makes some adjustments to the text pen, you need to switch off of the text pen to use keyboard shortcuts and other commands. So we're going to press the front button, invert button. Now we are no longer on the text pen, we're on the selection tool. Now I'm going to press the barrel button, the back button, and tap right in the center. This will trigger the radio menu, the text expand option. If it's a new command, it doesn't recognize it, it will pull this list up. You'll notice smile is already written here in voice command or shorthand. Doing action type, send a text. You can send a keyboard hotkey, text, open a site, open an app, click a spot on the screen like a mouse click, move to a screen location but don't click, and you can send modifiers or paste an image. It's very powerful. Now expand. What we're going to do here is we're going to on the field here that opens up the touch keyboard. We're going to click in the top left corner of the touch keyboard. There's this icon for emojis, and we're going to click on beaming face with smiling eyes. This is a bit intense for my needs, but it'll work for this video. Add to list. Yay, smile is now going to send a smile emoji. In the voice command panel, we're in the general tab. There's a current preset and a general one. Current preset, notice this says OneNote. This means that when I write the word smile, it will only send this inside of OneNote. It won't do it if another profile is active. So basically another application is open and Tablet Pro sees it as something else. All right, so here we have smile. In the general, we're going to go ahead and close this. We have this already selected. We're going to open the radio menu and click in the center. And now we have our wonderfully over-exuberant smiley face. Make people uncomfortable, just the right amount. He's too happy. We're going to press the front button to switch back to the text pen. Let's do another enter gesture. And just for fun, let me show you a couple different gestures here. When you swipe through, this will subtract or add a space. Again, down and left, we'll do an enter key. All right, let's do one last thing here. Let's change the case on this email address right here. Now, change case, this is a little tricky. As far as I know, there's not any fancy way of doing this. By the way, we're using Calibri 11 and the narrow rule lines, and this aligns well. All right, we're gonna press change case. Notice this has changed the case to camel case. We press it again, it won't do anything. And this is partly because we have the text pen selected. So we're going to shift over here. We're going to reselect this word and hit change case. Notice everything is capitalized, lowercase. Now, sometimes this is a funky thing and you need to reselect it for the keyboard shortcut to work again. Now I have this also on the radio menu. This is radio menu A. We're going to switch to B. See change case right here. We're going to tap on it and you can see that it has changed. Really useful if you're doing anything with a stylus and not a physical keyboard, because it can be a pain in the butt to try and change those letters. The cases is a whole bunch of extra presses. One other little fancy tip. Open the radio menu. We're going to switch back to radio menu A. I have right here, this is a little hard to see, I have the hand icon, the panning hand. Look how fancy that is. There is not actually a keyboard shortcut for this action. So this magic voodoo is something that I will explain later in this video. So keep watching and I'll show you how to do that. Now, very top left, this is the quick access toolbar. I have the panning hand. This is important. And the quick access bar, which may be down a little lower on your OneNote. If you click here, this little arrow, this again, this might be lower Then the top, you have the option of show below the ribbon. Let's put this down here. And because we have a simplified ribbon, always show ribbon, you can see it's moved down here. We don't want it down here. So let's go ahead and put that back. Show above the ribbon. All right, that's good. We have this option here for normal view. If you don't see normal view, this option is to the far right, down just a little bit, normal view. If we go to the view tab, you can see full page view. I want to also point out that we are using rule lines. These are narrow rule. And we're using Calibri 11 as the font size, and that will fit in here. So if you're typing or you're writing or you're using the text pen, this will fit in the rule lines and will make your work look pretty. Now up here, this ribbon, let's click on more commands. What you'll see in this option here, you can grab different functions from this side. There's popular commands here. What we want is we want the panning hand. You can switch from popular commands to all commands, and we'll just scroll down to the letter P, which rhymes with trouble, which stands for pool. And you can see panning hand, you'd click on here and click on add. Once it's over on this side, you can grab it and you can move it up or down, put it at the very top spot. And this is not actually critical, but it is going to be used, and I do want you to know how to do this. So view, you can click on full page view. We don't want this right here. We want something cleaner. So we're going to click on full page view again. I was happy once, at least. So we want to use this little down arrow in the right corner. We want simplified ribbon, show tabs only. We want to make sure it's show quick access toolbar. And then we're going to touch on the screen somewhere on the canvas. We don't actually want this right here. So we're going to click on full screen layout. Again, you can do that with this little expand to full page view icon right over here. If we click here at the top, again, it's going to show us everything that we have here that's still very accessible, but we're going to have this nice radial menu that I'm using. This is something that's very significant to me. I can do almost everything I want to do now in OneNote, and I can do it while I'm holding my tablet. That's the whole point. I want to be able to sit on the couch or be standing or sitting in bed and holding the tablet with one hand and feeling effective and productive with the other. Oh, and if you switch between A and B, that will erase the mapping for the outside ring. Let's go ahead and take a look at this real quick. It's called previous two radial actions. Radial menu we have set to last. This is the Tablet Pro Studio interface. And this is OneNote selected in the program profile. I have auto switch on, so this will do this on its own. The trackpad, hotkey panel modes, this is set to float. That's what this, probably not possible to see here, unless I'm actually using the palm rejection part. But that's down there, and you could switch that to something like an artist pad. This is just simple touch buttons. So you have, you know, undo and change case and that over here. So if you don't mind that extra bit there, that's an option. I'm not doing that because of the palm rejection issues inside of the Z13. Now, if you're taking notes in OneNote and you want to be able to see a meeting, you're doing either a Zoom or a Teams meeting or something where you're watching another person, you're watching a video, we have here in the file menu, there's an option to set window opacity. Let's drop the window opacity to 75%. Now you can see right behind here, if I was playing a video, I could actually make eye contact still. I mean, it's computer eye contact, but eye contact with whatever I'm watching, the person that's talking to me. And let's go ahead and click on these. And I can take notes this way. And then again, if I wanted to switch to the text pen, just click right here, tap where I want to start writing, tap where I want to start writing, and then can just write. And it's actually very intelligent handwriting to text conversion. And I love that it's instant. This is so much easier. All right, a couple little quick notes. If you want to select multiple things, you can just drag up and left and it will select that whole bit. All right, let's go ahead and change the opacity back. All right, so let's talk about this move shortcut. When I tap on this move icon, what this is doing, this is sending Alt 1. So here you can see move is selected. In order to get to that, I'm going to the right top corner and clicking on the three dots, the ellipsis there. You can see over here in the radial menu image that the hand is selected. The actions keyboard is in type of action. Action, the number one key is pressed. And modifiers Alt. So this is pressing Alt and then pressing 1, which triggers the action in the first position over here. The second position, third position would be Alt 1, Alt 2, Alt 3. So that's how we're triggering this. And this is giving us the option of having a large, clean UI and also using the Move tool. I like this for so many different reasons. Okay, so now let's see this icon right here, the selection. Let's see, what do they call it? Select objects, yeah. Okay, so select objects. This is not clicking in the right location, so let's adjust that. So you can see select is selected. We're going to go here, we're going to drag up, and that should now be set. There we go. And it all works quite well now. By the way, periods, you draw a period by drawing a circle, not doing a dot. Dot doesn't recognize the same way. So draw a little tiny circle, a comma, little comma. And again, enter is down and left. You can do that even in a blank space. Well, I am sure that I forgot a handful of things that may make this. I did forget. Okay, let's look. There's a couple of settings that you need inside of the options. Okay, so we're going to tap on the top ellipsis. I'm going to go to File on the far left. Go all the way down to the very bottom to the word Options. And then here inside of Options, we have a couple things we need to turn on. Let's go to Advanced. We're going to scroll down. And inside of Pen, these are my settings. Automatically switch between inking, selecting, typing, and panning. This option I have turned off. Enable automatic handwriting recognition on, smooth ink when drawing with a pen. This is not really important. What you need is enable the scratch out gesture while inking. This is important. Those ones right there. Put your questions in the comment section. If you're interested in the Tablet Pro Studio app, you can find that in the Microsoft Store. I'll also put links to it in the description. All right, guys, thank you for watching. Until next time, stay creative and have a wonderful day.